Hi, and welcome to ZappySys 101. Today we're going to review how to read JSON data from local files or a REST API web service using the ZappySys JSON Source component. From Visual Studio, go to File, New Project. Under Templates, Business Intelligence, select Integration Services Project. I will call mine JSON Source Demo. Click OK to create the project. On the left side, you should see the SSIS toolbox. If you don't see the SSIS toolbox, right-click in the blank space and select SSIS Toolbox. You should see a set of tasks that start with ZS. These are the ZappySys tasks. Drag and drop the Data Flow task onto the Control Flow tab. Double-click the Data Flow task to see the Data Flow Designer. Now that we are in the Data Flow Designer, look in the toolbox for the ZappySys components. They begin with ZS. Drag and drop the component labeled ZS JSON Source. Double-click to change its properties. The first option is to choose an access mode. This defines how we will retrieve JSON data. We can do this in a few ways, via direct JSON string, getting the JSON from a file, or getting it from a URL or web service. For instance, if you wanted to parse a JSON string, you could enter values in this box. Here we have a simple JSON object of a bookstore, some of its inventory, and its location information. When we click Preview, we see that the data has been parsed into one row. The locations were parsed properly, but the books are in a single column. That's where filters come in. We can tell the ZappySys JSON source component how to parse the data. We'll tell the filter how to parse the list of books and that we want the location information from the store as part of each row. We do this by leaving the Include Parent Columns checkbox checked. Click Preview. Now we have three rows, and each row has the location information and the data for that book. Now let's look at getting data from an ODATA service. Here we see a URL for some order details. We'll tell the ZappySys JSON source component what type of JSON format we expect back from the web service. In this case, by setting it to ODATA, the JSON source component will take care of paging for us. Notice that we're filtering the results to just return us the value object in the ODATA. We will also uncheck the Include Parent Columns checkbox as we only want the data returned by our value filter. Click Preview. The results appear to have been parsed properly. Next, we can configure the columns. The ZappySys JSON source component will determine our columns based on the data we're retrieving. Here we can alter the names or data types of our columns. For instance, I'm going to use a lowercase d for order ID and product ID. The last two sections are the general and error handling sections. In general, we can configure the name and description information for the task. Click OK to return to the Data Flow Designer. Next, we'll drag over the ZappySys trash destination so we can do a quick test. Connect the path between the two components. Right-click on the path between the two components and add a data viewer. Click Save, and then start to execute. Notice that the column names we set flowed through properly, and that we have retrieved over 2,000 rows of data from our source. This has been an overview of how to use the ZappySys JSON source component. For more videos like this, subscribe to the ZappySys YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.